Hello, I'm Matt, and this Loxley Quality Time tutorial is to help you with this painting, The Timeless Barn from the Cantisso collection. If you haven't already watched our techniques tutorial videos, please have a look at them before starting your project. They give you some valuable information about painting with the Quality Time range and help you get the most out of your quality time. This video contains specific information about your chosen painting, but we assume that you're already familiar with the general techniques covered in our tutorial videos. The Timeless Barn features an old barn at Emsworthy in the Dartmoor National Park, Devon. The area contains the largest concentration of Bronze Age remains in the United Kingdom, and the landscape is scattered with prehistoric stone sculptures and huts. Such signs of past occupation have probably led Dartmoor to being known for its myths and legends which have inspired artists and writers over the years. I've added a pheasant to this picture as it has adapted well, becoming a common sight in the open countryside since its introduction to the UK from Asia around the 10th century. Okay, so I'm going to start this painting with the sky, and I've mixed my blue, which is a pale blue, using 80% white approximately, and then the lighter of the two blues. And there is a technique video on painting skies which gives you more information. I recommend it's a good idea to look at that before doing this project. And I'm using the larger of my two brushes, the two brushes in your pack, because it's a big area. And I'm using horizontal brush strokes, nice smooth brush strokes. Put the paint on, then just go back over with not too much paint loaded on the brush and just smooth out any lines. You want as few lines in the sky as possible. It will always look a little bit patchy on stage one. It's okay, it's hard to get it completely smooth this stage. I'm painting around the main trunk areas of the tree, but the little branches, it doesn't matter, you can just paint right across these because these will show through. You can see it showing through here, and because the branches are a darker color, we'll paint that over the sky. And we want to be able to see the sky through the branches, so just go right across as if the branches weren't there, like this. And I'm just adding a little bit more white as we come down the picture towards the horizon here. You'll notice from your photo that the sky is paler towards the horizon here. I'm just getting the sky the other side of this tree as well. So I'm coming right down to the horizon, this hill line here. I'm going to paint around the edge of the canvas while I've got the same color mix of this blue. Notice that there's no staples or pins on the side of the canvas, and we've done this deliberately so it looks finished even if it's not framed. There's a lot of cloud in this picture, so I'm working round these areas with the blue, just painting the areas between the cloud like this. Even if you have to use other than horizontal brush strokes, always finish off horizontally so you get all the any lines going the same way. It's a good idea to mix up enough blue so you can keep going with the same shade approximately, so you're not mixing again as a different shade of blue. Keep referring to your photograph just to check where it is sky and where it is cloud. Now I've done some blue, I'm going to put in some of the white on the cloud, and it's better if you don't use horizontal brush strokes, just go in the direction of the cloud. Putting the paint on thickly so that you can get a bit of the texture of the cloud. Most of these are just white, but this cloud in the middle has got a bit of colour in it. So I've just mixed a little bit of blue with the white just to give it a bit of a shade there. So it's quite different brush strokes, you'll notice, like that. Okay, so I'm now working on this hill behind the barn here, and on this side of the hill I've mixed up mainly yellow with a small amount of light brown, and you'll notice from the photo that it's more yellow on this side, so that's why I've used more yellow in the paint mix. Referring to my photograph and working my way across, I'm using the larger brush again, and I'm using horizontal brush strokes and just painting around the larger branches of the tree and the stone wall, so I don't want to get it onto this area of the stone or the barn. I'm painting over these tree areas here. It'll show through so I can pick those up at stage two, keeping the paint off the barn roof. And then as we get over this side, I've added slightly more brown, slightly moorland browny colour, but the yellow is from the sun. The majority of the Dartmoor National Park is moorland. It's not farmed at all. And then for the left-hand side across here, I've mixed white with the light brown. There is a very small amount of yellow in there still, but mainly white and brown. And I'm just merging that in with the yellow. Just added a bit more yellow in just to make it blend in with the other side of the hill here. You don't want it to be a sharp line. I've just put a bit of paint the other side of this tree, and I've left the tree trunk without any paint on there. A nice crisp horizon. I'm now painting the sun, and I'm just using pure yellow, like this round area in the middle of the tree, and then the rays coming out. I'm using the small brush, and I'm using the very tip of the brush, following the ray out with my brush strokes like this, and then just using the yellow mixed with a small amount of white, so it's a paler yellow coming away from the sun. And again, you paint over the branches because they'll show through, so I can see where the branches still need painting in. So I'm now painting the field in front of the hill, and I've mixed a very pale colour using mostly yellow, 90% yellow, with just a small bit of green. You'll see from the photo that the field is quite yellow looking. It's obviously sort of a dead grass or wintry grass. So it's almost yellow, but just a hint of green in it. And I'm using my small brush because it's quite a small area, and I'm using horizontal brush strokes, just nice gentle brush strokes. I'm keeping the paint off these stone areas here and not painting on the tree. When I was doing my hill, I came too low down with the hill colour, so I'm just going over with the yellow to lighten that up. So I can lighten colours or make them darker just by painting over another layer of paint. All the brush strokes are going horizontally. Okay, so I'm now working on this barn wall here, and I've mixed a very pale grey using almost all white with just a very small amount of the dark brown, and I'm using a small brush doing horizontal brush strokes, and you'll notice that again that the outline's showing through, so I'm just keeping to this area, keeping off the roof, just cut along the line like that. If you leave a bit of texture in the paint, it looks more realistic, like the stones. Mixed it slightly darker for this end elevation of the barn. I've added a little bit more of the dark brown to make the paint a darker shade of grey. From that line on, I'm just doing it darker this side. And also in the middle of the wall here, it's darker. So I'm just going back in and with a darker shade. Gives it more character. You've got different shades of grey going on. Where the barn door, you can see from the outline, I'm using just pure dark brown. Blocking this in, being careful just to keep to the area, working up to the edge there and around these stones. And then again, these little windows or whatever they are. So I'm now doing the barn roof, and I've mixed this pale red using mainly white with a very small amount of red. Always mix the colours on the paler side, as they tend to turn out darker than you would imagine. And I've cut across the top, so I've got a nice crisp line there. And then I'm painting in the direction of the slope of the roof with the small brush, so I can get right up to the edge. And even if I work along with my brush strokes just to get this edge, always finish up in this direction. And you'll see that the paint isn't thoroughly mixed, so I'm getting red and white streaks, which is what I want, because it looks like the actual tin roof lines in the roof. So I'm now doing these stone walls, and I've mixed slightly darker grey using approximately 80% white and 20% dark brown. And I'm going to vary this mix using less brown in certain areas. I need contrast in the stone. If it's all the same colour, it tends to lose the detail. And you'll notice I'm painting the individual shapes of the stone so that it retains the individuality of the stone. And with a paler colour, I'm coming in this back wall here. I'm using brush strokes in the direction of the stone. The stones lie this way, so I'm using brush strokes like that. Slightly paler for these stones sticking up here. You can leave a bit of texture in as well, make it more interesting. I'm painting more with the edge of the brush here and leaving gaps where I can put the green moss between. I'm putting some of the stones in front of the barn here using very small brush strokes, just with the tip of the brush. So keep the brush loaded and just use the tip of it like that. Refer to your photograph. I'm keeping to the areas, so this stone is further away. So I've done that patch, that colour. Slightly paler for the wall here. And I'm finishing off in the direction of the stone, the natural contour of the structure of the stone. I don't want to go onto the tree or the hill. I'm just working up to that edge. And these stones that are more rough, it doesn't matter which direction you paint them in. So I'm using different brush strokes in different directions to give the impression of weathered stone. using the larger of the two brushes now, and I'm doing the grass. This is made up of a mixture of yellow and green, and I want to vary the mix in places a bit more yellow, like across here where it's the grass is paler. Roughly you need 50% yellow and 50% green, but the more yellow you add, the paler the colour, and the more green you add, the darker you'll get. So for over here, it's very pale, and even this area here is totally yellow, so I've just added pure yellow in here, and then I'm coming back with my green. You can almost mix it on the canvas. The more greens, the varied you can get, the more realistic the grass will look. Although I'm cutting up at this angle so as not to paint on the rock here, I'm finishing off with horizontal brush strokes for this area where the grass is further away. And there is a technique video which will give you more information to help with painting grass. Technique video is called Painting Trees and Foliage, but it covers grass as well. It's amazing what small areas you can paint with this larger brush just by using the very tip of it. So nice gentle brush strokes. This is quite a yellow area again, so I'm just adding yellow in with my mix. For the grass nearer, I'm going slightly darker here, still quite a pale green, and I'm painting it going up towards the bird and the rocks here. So I'll be going in this direction with sort of wiggly brush strokes because it's very rough grass, keeping it nice and pale around the pheasant so I don't lose the character of this bird. And in stage two, when you're doing the grass in stage two, you build up the darker colours on top of the pale. And you'll notice here, it doesn't matter about my brush strokes. It's not as important that they don't need to go horizontally. The more varied the brush strokes, the better the finished effect will be. Working on this foreground grass now. And what you'll notice is that I'm bringing the lines away from the birds and the rocks. So this remains the central feature. Slightly darker greens now, picking up these lines. So your eye is being led into the centre, directing the viewer's eyes to the centre of the picture. I'm using more paint on my brush now, so I'm getting some of the texture in the foreground here. And then when these green areas are dried, I'll go in with a paler colour and fill in between. I'll show you here, I'm going with a very pale mix and filling in between. I've kept the lines and filled in between with the paler colour. I'm now painting these rocks. You can use whichever brush you feel most comfortable with. I'm using the larger one here and being very careful just to keep to the outlines here. I've mixed up this grey using mostly white with a tiny amount of dark brown. And you'll notice I'm painting the individual shapes of the rocks, and this way they won't all merge into each other. It's important to keep them as individual rocks so that they look right on the picture. So even though they're the same colour, if you paint them as different shapes, it'll show in the painting. You can vary the grey mix a bit just to suit, or study the photo, see where the rocks are paler. So you see I've kept the shape of this rock different to this one. The Dartmoor National Park is one of the largest areas of granite in Britain. 241 square miles of granite under the national park. It covers two-thirds of the whole park, and these outcrops are the granite breaking through the moorland. They're quite a feature of this area. The larger outcrops of granite rock are known as tors. I'm now doing the moss on these stone walls, and I'm using the small brush and using green, just green, using the tip of the brush and keep loading it, putting the paint on quite thick between these stones here, and then some areas are totally mossy. This will be darker in stage two. This is just stage one, so if it looks a bit patchy, it's fine. Again, I'm keeping the shape of the rocks and just filling between them. There's some rocks that are quite distinctive, like this one here, and then others that it doesn't matter so much. You don't have to be so precise. It'll still look right. So you can see the outlines are showing through. Just very small brush strokes, just picking out where the moss is, looking at my photograph and using the outlines. They've obviously not been disturbed for some time with all this moss growing on it. Like the old saying, rolling stones gather no moss. And these ones have just unspoilt and left alone. I'm using the green round here to bring out these rocks, make them stand out. Small dabs of the green on quite thick. And then in other areas you can brush it out quite thin. It's making them stand out more. So I'm now doing stage one of the pheasant. I'm using my small brush, and I've mixed up this colour using 50% red and 50% yellow. Using the very tip of the brush and not putting the paint on too thickly. I want to smooth it out so there's no brush marks. A nice smooth colour. Painting around the detail on the wing, there's a little white patch which I'm leaving blank. So just keep to the outline. get the paint on, and then I'm finishing the brush strokes off in this direction, the way the feathers lie, so it looks right. And then the tail, just the very tip of the brush again. It's the body of the bird. Now above the wing, I'm just going to add a tiny bit more yellow in here and just blend that in so it's a bit brighter there. Then I'm going to go onto the head, which is dark blue. And again, using the small brush very carefully. I'm not painting the ring around its neck or the red bit of its face. So it's just the back of its head here. It will look a bit patchy at this stage, but that's fine. Then I'm going to do the face, which is mostly red with a tiny bit of white or even yellow. Just to make it a bit paler, I'm doing its cheek over its eye. And then the neck band, I'm just going to strengthen that with the white, putting the paint on quite thick. And I can also use this white for the beak as well, and the bit on the wing here. That's stage one of my bird done. So I'm going to paint the trees, and I'm using a mixture of brown and white for the trunk, and then dark brown for the branches. And you can see the outline is quite clear to see. I'm using the small brush and just the very tip of the brush and keep loading it. And you'll need to be great patience for this to get it right. Just take your time. Branches are getting thinner as they go up, and work up in the direction in which the tree grows. This will look right in the finished painting. Rome wasn't built in a day, and you have to just slow down for some of these areas. And if Rome was built in a day, it wouldn't look right either. Different shades of brown showing through here with the white, different amounts of the white mix. You go over the trunks at stage two, but it just makes it look more interesting. You've got a bit of texture in there. You'll notice that the branches get more at the top, so there's more of them, sort of branch out a bit more. Just putting a bit of dark brown in here. So this is stage one completed now, and I've done a lot of the branches here. I will be putting in further branches in stage two, but the shapes of the trees are all there. The moss is all complete on these stones here and on these rocks, and the grass is all complete. Right, I'm now on stage two of the sky, and I've mixed this, again it's a pale blue but slightly darker, using horizontal brush strokes with my large brush, just working my way across. And you'll notice that a lot of the streakiness and brush strokes from stage one disappear at this stage. Picture starts to come together, it's more rewarding. And again, I'm just working a bit paler down towards the horizon, strengthening all these areas, going back over again. Picture starts to get more depth at stage two, much paler towards the horizon. I've got a sufficient blue behind the trees, so I'm not going to go over this area because I'll lose a lot of my branches. So I'm just working on the main sky, which you can see going back in with the clouds, so strengthening the clouds as well. This is just pure white on the clouds, and then a white with a small amount of blue for the off-white clouds. And the paint I'm putting on quite thickly, so it'll have texture. I want them to look three-dimensional slightly, so you see the paint going on thick. Small dabs of brush strokes, and I'm referring to the photo for the shapes of these clouds. So use the outlines and your photo. So now I'm doing stage two of the hills and just picking out some of the detail. So you'll notice from the photo that in the background there is some trees and some little hedges and things. And just with a slightly darker shade of the first colour, so it's yellow just with a bit more light brown, I'm selectively doing some of the detail. You can just strengthen up the yellow as well, places like this where it's been missed, and make it a bit more stronger colour. Very gentle brush strokes with this little brush, the smaller brush, just tickling the surface. Across to the left, I'm putting in these trees here, and just a bit more detail. Slightly more browner to the left here, making a bit more varied the vegetation. Again, I'm just keeping to the hill area, not onto the sky, and not painting over the branches as well. I don't want to lose the hard work I've done on these branches. Just touching up between them, a bit of yellow here. Just pushing and pulling the colours till you're happy. I'm just going to do stage two of the sun, again with a small brush, and I'm just strengthening the yellow, so it's just pure yellow on there for the sun, and then the rays coming out again, where I've lost some of the detail with when I was painting the tree. Nice gentle strokes and up through the branches, and then I'm just adding a bit of white to the yellow as they get further away. So just hardly any paint on the brush, and you're just influencing the canvas with the small amount of paint that is on the bristles. So I'm now doing stage two on these fields, and I'm not exactly going to cover the whole field. I'm going in with a slightly darker colour, just putting in some of the detail. Mainly yellow again, but with just 20% green. So just putting in the hedgerows and just a bit of interest in the field here. Again, I'm using horizontal brush strokes, blending it in with the hill behind. So I'm now doing stage two of the stone wall of the barn, and I've mixed a darker grey. I'm not going over the whole area, I'm being selective and picking out the detail of the stones. So just very small brush strokes with the tip of the brush. You can do some of these areas, there's more stone, and then there's some areas where there's less stone. You're not covering the whole area. And keep loading the brush as you need. Put a bit of texture in so the paint can go on quite thick. You don't have to follow exactly the outline, but just use them as a guide. This wall's quite a bit darker, so I'm putting the stones closer together. So I'm now doing stage two of the barn roof, and I'm using slightly darker red, 20% red and 80% white. And I'm using the same brush strokes as before, so I'm cutting along the top and then using brush strokes the same angle as the roof. You can put the paint on fairly thick. And again, I've not mixed it thoroughly, so I'm getting the red and white streaks in with the pink, which is fine because it looks more realistic. And with the texture, you can leave lines in the paint as well. So keep loading your brush. Can afford to put quite a bit of paint on. Just going over these stones now, slightly darker mix. You can vary this, you can use this grey made of 80% white and 20% dark brown, and then patches of lighter as well. So you're wanting a bit of contrast. And I'm putting the paint on quite thick with these dabs here, so that it looks like the individual stones. And then just working my way across and going over the walls again. Try and keep the shape of them. Keep loading your brush. I'm just using the small brush because this is quite fine detail. Looks quite interesting if you just put bits of white on as well, like this here, in with the grey mix. Looks more like natural stone then. And I'm doing these stones here, not getting too much on the green, so I'm leaving the green for the moss. Putting the paint on quite thick. Again, like with the roof, I've not mixed the paint thoroughly, so on my brush there's grey and white in the same brush stroke. So I'm now doing stage two of the grass, and I'm using the small brush and quite a different technique here. I'm using either pure green or green mixed with a very small amount of the light brown, and I'm putting in the individual grass blades. So some areas I'm just shading it all out like this, and then other areas I'll leave the actual brush strokes in, and I'm doing them in the direction that they would grow up, so as they would grow out of the ground. And I'm not covering the whole area, just being selective, putting the paint on quite thick, very small brush strokes. And again, I'm remembering to do these lines coming out from the pheasant and from the central rocks. You'll see in a minute as this forms that it's directing you in towards this pheasant. You can go back into these areas if it's too dark. You can take some paint out and just play around, just tickling the surface of the canvas. If any areas go too dark, you can add back in yellow. This actually looks quite interesting. You want as many shades of green as you can. I don't want to go too dark around the pheasant. I'll lose some of the character of it if it's lost in the grass. I want the bird to stand out. Because some areas I've not painted over deliberately, so we'll keep some paler areas. So I'm now doing stage two of the rock outcrop here, and I'm using the small brush and very small dabs with the tip of the brush, making them look 3D by just applying colour selectively. So I'm using different shades of a darker grey, which I've mixed using mainly white, but between 15 and 20% dark brown. And these are just very small dabs of colour. Keep referring to your picture and putting these in selectively. With just pure dark brown, I'm putting in tiny dots. Yeah, little specks that make it look really interesting. Blending it, the dark in with the moss there, and you can start to see this appearing. I love this stage, it sort of comes to life, starts to look so real. Tickling the surface, really gentle, nothing aggressive about the brush strokes there, and then just adding in the little dots. Be doing the moss again shortly at stage two, which will make that look more interesting. I'm now going to add bits of white in the rock, just like where these lichings are growing, and also in the lighter areas. So just keep loading the brush and using the very tip of it, keeping to the shape of the rock. Just keep working away at these areas till you're happy. It's up to you entirely how much detail you add in, and you can just go back in with the grey again and then the dark brown on its own. It's very small dabs. And then some of the areas where it's very light green, right down this edge here, if you look at the photo, there's some moss growing. Can add a bit of yellow in there. So you're trying to get as much contrast as you can. So I'm now doing stage two of the moss. I'm using green mixed with a very small amount of dark brown to give me a darker green. So you'll notice that the moss is very dark. And again, I'm not covering the whole area, but just working little paint dabs into this rock here. You can use sometimes just pure green, and you want to try and create contrast. And again, it'll be less patchy at this stage once you've had two layers of paint on. I'm now painting stage two of the bird, and for the back I've mixed dark brown with yellow and a bit of red, so I'm wanting this a bit darker. And again, I'm just following the way the feathers lie with my small brush, just small brush strokes, and use this for the tail as well. So you're getting a bit of reddy brown, dark reddy brown colour is what you wanted to achieve here, using the tip here with the tail. It up and into the body, and there's the loose feather sticking off there. There's a feather just sticking out of the back. Just make sure I get that in there like that. And then I'm just adding a bit of red on the back there, and just build these colours up. And you can add just dark brown on its own as well, and underneath here. I'm doing yellow and red just on the front, so without the dark brown. Just putting a bit of yellow in here. It's almost orangey colour. And then with pure dark brown, I'm doing speckles on the front of the bird. They stand out quite nicely against the reddy orange colour. Just blending the ones at the top into the feathers. It's very small brush dabs, just of the with the very tip of the brush. I'm going to put a bit of dark brown on the tail here now that's dried. Now I'm going to do the blue on the head. This is the dark blue. Make that a bit stronger there. For the second stage, it's always the colours are much stronger, more vibrant. There's a little flip on the back of the head, a little crest or whatever. Mostly red with a tiny bit of white on the face. And I'm going to just do a bit in the middle just with pure red. Just a tiny bit of white beak. And then for the eye, I'm going to use dark brown and just a tiny dot in the middle there. Last of all, I'll just put the white neck band back in, and also on the wing, just a little bit on the tail. Some bars, whatever they're called on the feathers there. With the dark brown, I'm doing stage two of the trees, and I'm just reinforcing these colours so that the trees stand out bolder, so it's not so patchy on the trunks here. Then I'm going to go in and add some more branches when I've got these, keeping a bit different shades of brown, not covering the whole area where I'm happy with the colour, and then just making them more bold, make them stand out, adding some of the small branches. I'm now going to add some more branches because I've had a break from doing branches, so it's quite good to come back to, as well as going over some of these bigger branches. I'm putting in some of these fine branches just with the very tip of the brush. Just load the end only, and you just use that to paint, so you're not clogging up your brush. Putting some of these branches in, again, not rushing, barely touching the surface of the canvas. Right, this is stage two of my painting finished, and I've covered the whole area. I've put more branches in on the trees, and the detail on the moss. I've gone over this moss so it stands out, and the rocks, the stones, all the moss in here. And I've just added tiny specks of yellow in the dark, and it just gives it so much more depth and character. And the grass, I've done all the detail on the grass. And again, I've just added little tiny yellow dots, and the bird is all complete. Okay, I'm now doing my shadows. I'm on stage three, and I've mixed my shadow paint using 50% red and 50% dark blue. And there is a technique video on painting shadows, which gives you more information. And these are marked on your guide in blue, where to put the shadows. These dark areas here, I'm using just the shadow paint as I've mixed it. I love this stage. It really brings out the character, the depth of the picture. For these areas here, I've added a little bit of water because the shadows in these areas, if you look at your picture, are softer. So by adding water, just makes the shadows look softer. You can go back in and go over any of these shadows to strengthen them. By the bird here, I'm using it watered down as well because it's a softer shadow. Painting the shadow under where its tail is as well. That's now stage three finished. All the shadows done. I've got the shadows on here and the barn. And the rocks, the stones and rocks here, and the pheasant. I'm now on stage four, which is the highlights, and there is a technique video on painting highlights, which I recommend you to have a look. Highlights are very small, so I'm using the smaller of the two brushes, and it's just using pure white paint. Where to do the highlights are marked on your colour guide in red to show you where to put them. You can also refer to your photograph as well. Putting on the paint quite thickly, just putting some very fine lines just on the top of the barn here, where the sun's just catching it on the top of the tin roof. And just on the tree trunk here where the sun's catching it, and this branch here, it's just like where the sun just catches the bark. And just these little areas here where the sun's catching the stones on the tree, top of the wall there. So I'm just putting some highlights on this, these stones under this tree where the sun's catching it. It could be a bit of moisture even that's just reflecting the sun. It just gives them another dimension on the tuft of the grass there. Just doing some tiny little highlights here on top of this stone wall where the sun's catching it, around the top there. Doing the highlight on the front of the pheasant here where the sun's catching it. Okay, so that's my picture finished. Stage 4 completed, all the highlights done, ready for hanging up or framing. I've really enjoyed this painting. Are you ready to give it a go? Goodbye.